Tunes since I was a little kid. You know, the best thing about the Looney Tunes is that they represent us, each and every one of us. They're part of Americana, part of our mainstream culture. They become members of our families. I mean, you don't have to go far to find out how close to us they really are. Think about, what's up, Doc? Or, you're despicable. Or, that's all, folks. These are phrases we all know, spoken by characters we recognize and understand. Probably because most of the time, they're more human than we want to give them credit for. And I think that's why they're true American treasures. However, the Looney Tunes and their irreverent brand of humor are products of their time. Unfortunately, at that time, racial and ethnic differences were caricatured in ways that may have embarrassed and even hurt people of color, women, and ethnic groups. Now, nobody intended it, but that's what happened. Now, some of the cartoons here reflect some of the prejudices that were commonplace in American society, especially when it came to the treatment of racial and ethnic minorities. Now, these jokes were wrong then, and they are wrong today. But removing these inexcusable images and jokes from this collection would be the same as saying they never existed. So they are presented here to accurately reflect a part of our history that cannot and should not be ignored. But I also want to point out that the Looney Tunes were made by the studio that supported hiring the first black animator, Frank Braxton, and that encouraged women voice artists like June Foray to become as recognizable as their on-screen characters. All that said, there's only one original, and we are so proud to present the Looney Tunes here for their enduring entertainment value, uncut and restored, just as they originally appeared. So sit back, enjoy the following collection of shorts. And I must tell you personally, I think Porky never looks so good. I'm Whoopi Goldberg, and welcome to the Looney Tunes Golden Collection. Like many of you, I love cartoons, and I've been a fan of the Looney Tunes since I was a little kid. You know, the best thing about the Looney Tunes is that they represent us, each and every one of us. They're part of Americana, part of our mainstream culture. They become members of our families. I mean, you don't have to go far to find out how close to us they really are. Think about, what's up, Doc? Or, you're despicable. Or, that's all, folks. These are phrases we all know, spoken by characters we recognize and understand. Probably because most of the time, they're more human than we want to give them credit for. And I think that's why they're true American treasures. However, the Looney Tunes and their irreverent brand of humor are products of their time. Unfortunately, at that time, racial and ethnic differences were caricatured in ways that may have embarrassed and even hurt people of color, women, and ethnic groups. Now, nobody intended it, but that's what happened. Now, some of the cartoons here reflect some of the prejudices that were commonplace in American society, especially when it came to the treatment of racial and ethnic minorities. Now, these jokes were wrong then, and they are wrong today. But removing these inexcusable images or jokes from this collection would be the same as saying they never existed. So they are presented here to accurately reflect a part of our history that cannot and should not be ignored. I also want to point out that the Looney Tunes were made by the studio that supported hiring the first black animator, Frank Braxton, and that encouraged women voice artists like June Foray to become as recognizable as their on-screen characters. All that said, there's only one original, and we are so proud to present the Looney Tunes here for their enduring entertainment value, uncut and restored, just as they originally appeared. So sit back, enjoy the following collection of shorts. And I must tell you personally, I think Porky